Hello Ramesh, are you there? Okay friends, let me start. Yeah, before going to the data science, I'm saying friends, this is an interactive session. Everyone should interact, then only you will get the information. Otherwise it is difficult. Okay, when I say the data science course, every time the data science is an interactive session. Okay, yeah, before going to the data science, please tell me friends, what is the data? What is the meaning of a data? Can I say the data is a information? The information related to anything, right? If you go to any organization, they might store their employees data, revenue data, and also their sales data, manufacturing data. Okay, they store their information, right? So simply we can say that data is something, it is a information. So now how the data is growing
nowadays? Excuse me.
Yeah, go ahead.
Can I ask a question?
Yeah, go ahead, Chitra.
Hello?
Yes, Chitra, go ahead.
Yeah, on data means like, yeah, like metadata is, I mean, the data structure, that is also your data, right? Metadata?
No.
You treat as a data.
Okay, I'm coming to your point, Chitra. So the big data, okay. Metadata or small data, you know, those are the, based on the data storage, you are discussing about the storage part, but I am talking about what is the meaning of your data first.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. So the data might be anything, right? That might be a small data or huge data. What is data first? You are storing in somewhere, but logically data is a information. You are storing your information, right? Some time back, we introduced ourselves. So you have given brief about yourself so that I got some understanding about you, right? So indirectly you provided some information to me about yourself, right? So data is a information. So how the data is growing nowadays, friends? Okay, very drastically, exponentially data is growing, right? Now we are in a position to store both structured data and unstructured data through social media. We are getting, okay, millions and millions of the records for each and every second and millisecond. So the data is growing like anything, right? Let's say if you take a simple example, okay, are you aware of the Indian telecom market? Who is the major network provider in India? Are you aware of the Intel? So Airtel is one of the mobile network provider in India. Okay, he is having almost 40% of the market in India. Just I can assume the customer base of the Airtel is around 30 crore in India. Just assume this is the rough number I am giving. Okay, if this is the case, okay, per day, for each customer, how many transactions they do, friends, per day? When I say the transaction, that might be incoming call, outgoing call, SMS, MMS, or whatever it may be. Okay, so how many transactions we can expect per person?
Yeah, unlimited.
Minimum I can expect 10, right?
I'm sorry. Yeah, I know. I'm just, it's like huge. 30 crores means like huge, huge, huge amounts of data.
Actually, I will explain. The 30 crore is the customer base per day. Per customer, if he is doing minimum 10 transactions, even in the internet browsing, once he browses that one, that stores as one of the record, minimum if they do 10 per day, we will be having the number of records is 300 crore. This is only for one day. If it is for 1 month, around 6,000 crore, right? Okay.
Yes.
So whenever I say the Airtel are huge customers, they won't store their data 1 day or 1 month. They generally store their data years on years, right? So that you can imagine, okay, this is a small example, but when you go to the manufacturing industry or something and spatial analysis or somewhere, for each and every millisecond, they capture millions of the records, friends. Okay, the same case even through social media also. Now, the data is very huge nowadays. Then where we have to store this data? is it possible to store this data in my hard local hard disk, or is it possible to store this one in an Excel file or text file? One, here you have to check two things. First of all, it is not safe, and the second point is we won't be able to store this much huge data, right? Then where we
yes.
have to store this data? Yeah, Ruchi and Reshma, Ramesh, you can use your chat box, friends, as I am not able to hear you because of your mic problems and settings. You can use your chat box. Where we store this data? Simple logic.
Distributor.
We store our data in a database, right? The database
yeah,
might be anything. Generally, we say Oracle or Teradata. Now, everyone is calling it as a Hadoop. Actually, Hadoop is exactly not the database. Okay, it is a framework. Here, we can process and we can store our data. Okay, here, we can keep all our data, right? Now, here the basic question is, friends, so many IT people are working on this particular area. Okay, they are doing ETL or they are storing their data by processing their data. A lot of IT people are working on Oracle, Teradata and different okay, database and different systems. They are storing the data. Now the point is, as a business person, if I am investing some amount on anything, on any exercise, obviously I will expect some returns, right? Otherwise I won't invest actually. That is the criteria any business people follow, right? But just if you take any example, any of the business person, obviously each and every company nowadays, they are storing their information, they are maintaining, okay, in one of the database or in one of the source. For that one, they are maintaining a lot of infrastructure, they are recruiting so many IT people, and they are purchasing all these tools, stuff, okay, they are maintaining their data, right? Now, the basic point is they are investing a lot of amount in the above exercise, the entire exercise. They are capturing the data and they are storing the data. Okay, they have very huge IT team is there. What the advantage they are getting out of this entire exercise, friends? What the benefit they are getting actually?
They want to make quick business decision based on the relevant data.
Okay, you are referring business decisions, right?
Business, yes.
Okay, the basic question is, how can I take the business decision? So I am the end user, I mean I am the business head. So you are storing all your data in one of the database, how to take the business decision? So if I ask how my business is working, if you open that millions and millions of the records, if you show to me, then what I can do with that one? I won't be able to do anything by looking into this huge data, right?
Yeah, you have to get the intelligent data, whatever the relevant, and after analysis, you...
Perfect. You are coming to the point, after the analysis, okay, you can take some business decisions, right?
Yeah.
So, that's what analytics came into the picture, friends. To perform the analysis, okay, whatever the huge data you are having, okay, as a end user directly, you won't be able to utilize that one directly. You won't be able to take any decisions unless performing the analytics. Now you have to understand what is the analytics. Analytics is something, whatever the data you are having from the data, okay, you have to study that data. You have to identify the hidden patterns and hidden relationships of your data. Okay, it should help to improve their business. Okay, in the form of a summary reports or predictive models or a machine learning algorithms, whatever the things you wanted to implement, you can implement. The final objective is, by looking into this data, by analyzing their data, you have to provide some valuable information to them so that it should help them to improve their business. Okay, when we are performing analytics, what we can do is, we can explain what happened in the past in their business, what is happening right now, what is going to happen in future. We can explain all the details so that they can take some appropriate business decisions, friends. That's what analytics came into the picture. Now tell me, without having this analytics exercise, is there any advantage of the entire above exercise?
No.
No, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, up to some extent they might use the data. Let's say
data.
If I am using ICICI Bank, or HDFC bank or GE money card, okay, some point of time, if I go and visit that particular bank and if I ask, I required my last 6 months transactions, they have to provide that one. Okay, that is some cases they have to maintain that data. For that is the only reason you need not to maintain years on years of the data only for these type of your requirements. These type of your requirements is only 5 to 10%. The remaining 90% in all the areas why they are storing the each and every data is information is more important to understand their business in detail. Clear, friends?
Mm-hmm.
Now I am saying analytics is very important in the real-time scenario to take any business decisions, right? Now who will do this work? Who will perform this analytics? Are you aware of any designations, friends, who do this work? Ramesh, Reshma and Ruchi, you are not responding, friends. Could you please use at least your chat box? Who performs this analytics, friends? You might hear the different designations like data analyst, statistical analyst, business analyst, right? And everyone, now everyone is calling it as a data scientist. Okay, now, okay, the people who are having this type of a designation, they can perform all these analytics stuff, friends. Now, tell me, if you have the understanding, what is the exact difference between this data analyst, statistical analyst, business analyst, and data scientist, friends? As we discussed, these are the different designations, they can perform the analytics and they can provide the business decisions to the customers, right? In the form of your summary reports or predictive models. By understanding the historical data, they can estimate what is going to happen in future. They can do all this stuff. Then, okay, from we are hearing this data scientist word at max from last 3 years, right? Do you think the analytics is there in the market from last only 3 years?
More than that.
Yeah. So it is there from long time, but it is there with the different names. Those are called, here I listed few names, data analyst, statistical analyst, and business analyst. Now everyone is calling it as a data scientist. Okay, these are the people, they can perform the analytics on the given data and they can bring some valuable information out of your huge data. By processing your data, they can give some valuable information. Then the basic question is, earlier also we are having the analytics, now everyone is calling it as a data scientist. Then how the previous analytics is different with the current data scientist role? Okay, earlier we are having all these designations. I can say all these designations are as a synonyms, friends. Depends on the organization structure. Okay, they usually give the designations, but the major role of all these designations is, okay, by studying the data, okay, they have to provide some valuable information out of the data in the form of a summary reports or using some statistical techniques or predictive techniques. Okay, they have to perform the analysis and they have to provide the solutions. Now, more or less, the data scientist work is also similar, friends. The same work, he also does the same thing. He process the data and he has to generate the solutions to the different business customers. Then how the previous analytics is different with the current one? Any guess, friends? So I am going
different models and techniques they use to analyze now data scientist compared to in addition to the previous techniques, you know, models.
Mm-hmm.
Some different approaches and different way of analyzing to cater to specific groups or individual or something like that, you know, or organization.
Some extent, yeah, you are correct. I will explain that one.
Sure.
So, I'm not getting any response again. I'm saying, Uchi, Reshma and Ramesh, could you please respond, friends? So at least are you able to follow me? Do you have any questions so far? So the major difference is, friends, earlier we were performing the analysis only on the structured data. Now when it comes to the data scientist role, we can perform the analysis for the structured or unstructured or whatever it may be. We can perform the analysis irrespective of the type of a data. And also earlier when we are performing the analysis, mostly, Chitra, as you explained, we use some statistical technique, Chitra. For each and every statistical technique, we will be having some assumption. Really, if the data satisfies those assumptions, then only we can implement those techniques. But in real-time practice, that is very difficult to satisfy all the assumptions of the statistical techniques. That is the reason we won't be able to implement the techniques for all type of a business problems. Now when it comes to the data scientist, here we generate the solution not only based on the statistical techniques. Here we implement the machine learning algorithms also by using the statistical techniques, machine learning algorithms, NLP techniques, natural language processing techniques, irrespective of the type of a data, that might be a structured data, unstructured data. By studying the data, we provide the solutions. As a data scientist, he can perform the analysis for any type of a data, for any type of a business problem he can handle, and he should be in a position to generate the business solution. That is the major difference between the previous analytics and the current data scientist role, friends. Am I clear?
Yes, thank you.
Now try to understand what is the role of a data scientist in any organization. The role of the data scientist is, first he has to understand what is the business problem of the customer friends. Simply when I say the business problem of the customer, you can assume that this is simply a pain area of the customer. Let's say if I explain, I am running one business from last 5 years until last 3 years or 4 years. My revenue is increasing year on year. I am having almost 20% of the revenue margin is there until last year. But unfortunately, from last 1 year, my revenue is going down. I am maintaining the same product. I don't have any competitors, but I don't know the reason. This is a pain area for me, right, in my business. Also, if you go to any banking sector, they might say that, we are issuing different loans to our customers. Out of those customers are not paying the returns and EMIs on time. So because of that one, we are struggling a lot. Again, we are planning to issue the loans. Please identify among the customers to whom we have to issue so that we won't be able to get any challenges going forward. That is again a problem, right? If you go to manufacturing industry, they might say that, so our problem is whenever we are manufacturing, almost we are getting 20% of the defective products. How to stop that one? If you go to the health insurance, who are the more loyal customers? I mean, who are the more important customers to us to improve their revenue? How to identify those customers? Who are the bad customers? So all these are the pain areas of the different industries, right? So first you have to understand what is the problem of the customer, what is the pain area of the customer. By understanding that business problem, you have to provide the solution. How to provide the solution is, once you know the technique or machine learning algorithms, what you can do is, you can allocate based on the type of a business problem, you have to choose one of the technique that might be a statistical technique or a machine learning algorithm. You have to choose one of the technique to resolve this business problem. By understanding that business problem, once you are aware of the different statistical techniques and machine learning algorithms, you automatically came to know that which technique I have to implement on this particular problem. You came to know that. So once you are clear which technique I have to implement, this technique, whenever I have very huge data, I won't be able to do any mathematical calculations manually, right? So what I will do is, I will take one of the tool support to implement all these techniques. I will take one of the tool to implement this technique. Using the tool, finally, I will provide the solution. Am I clear, friends? In high level, this is the role of a data scientist. He has to understand the business problem of the customer. The business problem might be anything, might be from any industry. As a data scientist, he is not specific to any industry. Okay, he should be in a position to provide the solution for any industry. He is not restricted to any specific industry. He can provide the solutions for any industry. So based on the business problem, we have to identify which technique or a machine learning algorithm really fulfills this business problem. We have to understand that one first. To implement this particular technique or algorithm, okay, you have to use one of the statistical tool to perform all these analyses, and using that tool you can generate the solution. Finally, you have to generate that solution. You should be in a position to interpret that solution. Using that solution, you have to give the answer to the business problem of your customer. Now the question is, here I am using the tool is called R, right? Now Chitra, you are referring, you are aware of the Python. Okay, if you go to some other person, they might say that I am aware of SAS. That is also one of the statistical software. If you go to the Microsoft, they use Azure ML. Okay, now when it comes to the tools part, almost more than 30 different tools are there to perform all these techniques and algorithms, right? Okay, now in the real data science part, if you wanted to become a real data scientist, okay, a data scientist is not really specific to any industry or any domain or any tool. Am I clear? So the data scientist, what he has to do is, he has to focus more on this particular part. Even if you know one technique, I mean one tool, okay, how to implement these techniques in the tools, we are not the programmers. You need not to write lot of programming loops and this type of stuff. That level of the programming is not required. Here, based on few objects, we can directly generate the solutions using the tools. Those tools are specifically designed for performing the analysis. Okay, even when you are using the Python, okay, for the data preparation, you might use the coding part, but whenever you are running a model, okay, the direct inbuilt functions will be available to perform the analysis frames. Okay, as a data scientist, you should not run behind the tools. Okay, the problem with the tools is, earlier, almost 3 to 4 years, I used SAS. Now everyone is saying R or Python. Okay. Now if you move to the Microsoft, they use the Azure ML. If I go to the X company, they will be having their own tool. If you go to Y, they will be having their own tool. So is it possible time to time learning all these tools? Is it a right thing, friends? I'm saying even if you learn one tool, okay, using that tool, you can perform the techniques or algorithms. Even if you go to any other organization, if they are using some other tool, it will take oddly, if you know one tool and if you are aware of all the techniques, oddly within 10 days, you can pop up and you can get that knowledge, friends. That is not a really a difficult task. Okay, if you wanted to become a real data scientist, you have to focus more on the techniques and the machine learning algorithms. So why I'm giving that conclusion is, now what is the problem in the IT sector nowadays? So if you have the demand for the Java or something, so I'm not criticizing anything, friend, just I'm giving an example. Let's say I don't want it to go for the IT side. Again, I can give you the example here itself. Okay, just I'm working based on a specific tool. Okay, as I mentioned earlier, I worked on SAS, right? So if I am a programmer, just you can replicate the same thing too in the IT sector also. If I am using this tool, if there is any change in the market, obviously I have to go for the other tool, right? Again, I have to learn that tool. Again, the market got upgraded. Again, I have to go to the other tool. Agree? So time to time, what is happening? The tools very frequently changes, friends, in the market. According to that one, every time you should be in a learning phase, you have to learn all the tools. Again, we are not sure how long the tools exist in the market. Okay? So Chitra, you are referring, you are using Hadoop also, right? You mentioned you are aware of the Hadoop.
I'm aware of that. Yes.
Okay. Do you think the Hadoop really sustains in the market in the coming 5 years or 6 years? You're not sure, right? Everyone started developing their own products, right?
Yeah.
Okay, again, if that comes into the market, again, we have to go to learn that part. That is the challenge in the IT side. whenever the tools got upgraded, we have to learn time to time and we have to upgrade our knowledge. But when it comes to the data science or data scientist, that is not the scenario. Okay, whatever the things I am referring here, the techniques and your machine learning algorithms, okay, these techniques won't change at any point of time, friends. This is one-time investment. When I say the investment in the sense, I'm not talking about the money, I'm talking about the knowledge. Okay, once you learn all these techniques and machine learning algorithms, okay, this is one-time learning part. Whatever the technique I implemented 10 years back, I'm implementing the same technique now also. Technique won't change at any point of time, friends. But we may get the new techniques. Okay, if you learn 15 techniques, if the new techniques comes into the market, it won't erase all the remaining 15 techniques. Okay, the new technique can rectify one of the business problem. For the other business problems, anyway, we have to use the remaining 15 techniques.
Yeah.
Am I clear?
Yeah.
Okay, here the part is to become a real data scientist, what are the things we have to learn? Okay, majorly we have to focus on statistical techniques and machine learning algorithms. Okay, so here you have to spend almost 80% of the time, friends. Once you are comfortable with all these concepts and techniques, you can provide for most of the business problems, you can provide the solutions, okay, using one of the tool or something. But here majorly you have to focus most of the time here. Without understanding of all the techniques and the learning machine learning algorithms, going forward, you won't be able to provide a proper solutions in the real-time market, friends. Am I clear? And the remaining 20% of the time, you can put your time on tools, how to write the commands, how to execute those things, and how to perform these particular techniques or machine learning algorithms, okay, in R or Python. Okay, you have to spend the remaining 20% of the time there, friends. Okay, now if you go to the outside, they might keep different things in the training curriculum. They might give all these things: Hadoop, R, Python, SAS, Tableau. Finally, they provide statistical techniques and machine learning algorithms. These type of things in general, they provide that one. Okay. I'm very sure if any one of you working in the real-time side, you can imagine how many people will work on Hadoop, friends, for one requirement in any organization. Minimum two people, right? One is a developer, the other person is the admin, right? If it is a small organization, then both the works is done by only one person. I agree that one.
Mm-hmm.
But on one Hadoop requirement, one or two people are working on one requirement, then how we can imagine a data scientist can handle all these things, friends? Is it possible in real time? Okay, the problem here is the most of the people who are providing the training outside, the problem is most of them are from the IT background, friends. They are very comfortable with the tools. That is the reason what they are doing is they are spending 50 to 60% of the time on tools. They are wasting the time. When it comes to the statistical techniques and machine learning algorithms, they are learning a couple of techniques and they are practicing a couple of real-time examples. Okay, they are covering 2 to 3 techniques. Even if they cover all the techniques, they are giving the real-time exposure with the real-time examples on 1 or 2 techniques, and they are closing the course. After closing the course, if you move to the real-time side, then you see the real-time challenges. Okay, that is not the real data science course, friends. If anyone is teaching, if they are spending more than 40% of the time or 30% of the time on tools, if they are spending less time on the statistical techniques, you can just assume that they are really cheating you. Okay, if any institute or if any trainer, they are covering more than 70% of the time on statistical techniques and machine learning algorithms, then that is really a good institute. Okay, you can continue there. Okay, these are the different assumptions we are having in the market on the data science. Okay, to become a real data scientist, you should be aware of all these things. Once you are comfortable with these things, don't bother about the tool. Today I am using R, tomorrow I don't know which tool I am going to use it. So, some of you are working in real time, just you can imagine, to learn a new tool, once you are already aware of a particular tool, how many days it will take, friends? all the codes and all the everything is available even in Google also. If I wanted to perform any analysis, sentiment analysis or something, the direct codes will be available. Even directly you can communicate with the technical team of R or Python. They directly, these are the freewares, right? They can directly provide the codes also if you contact the support team. Am I clear?
Yes.
Now the next question is, at the time of the course, how many real-time projects we cover at the time of the course? That is the basic question, right, in general. Okay, in my course, this is specifically designed for the job-oriented program friends. Okay, I won't say I will cover one project or a two project at the time of the course. That is not the scenario. In the entire course, I will teach different 15 different techniques. Okay, within these techniques, these are including statistical techniques, machine learning algorithms, NLP techniques. I will cover all these techniques. Now, for each and every technique, I will cover one real-time project. When I say the real-time project, I won't consider the data sets from Google or somewhere, friends. Okay, whatever the projects I have done so far, out of that one, I will select one of the sample data. I will explain the real-time business problem, and I will show you how to execute that one, how to resolve that problem. So by completing this course, you should be in a position to cover almost for 15 different projects, friends. After covering one project in the classroom, I will give you one of the project as an exercise, and I will explain the business problem. Okay, within the given timeline, you have to submit that particular project so that you feel the comfortability of how the real-time things happens in the real-time market. Am I clear?
Yeah.
Do you have any questions so far, friends? Chitra? Ramesh?
No.
Yeah, Balki, are you there? I think you joined a little late, so do you have any questions? Please let me know, Balki. I'm not able to hear you. Even you can use your chat box. Okay, fine. So here we will cover one real-time project for each and every technique. Here the point is, you need not to bother about all the 15 techniques, friends. In the real-time, almost three techniques, the top three techniques can really resolve 70% of the business problems outside. Okay?
Excuse me, I have a quick question.
Yeah.
Is it the data will be on real-time data operations techniques you will cover, or is it offline you store data you want to teach analysis and all those things?
I didn't get your question.
The project real-time. No, the real-time project on the questions will be like on the streaming on that side, or is it on the data which is.
Yeah, I got your point, Chitra. So what I will do is, at the time of the course, now how I am giving the demo. Okay, likely I will open the business problem. What is the business problem? I will explain. I will show you what is the data set I am using, what the inputs I got from the customer, and I will show you how I am executing that one, using which technique, why I am using that technique. I will explain, and I will show you how I am executing that one using R, and how finally I am generating the solution, how we present it to the customer. I will give you the complete details.
Okay.
Once I have done that one, I will share that video with you. I will share the sample data, and I will share the R code and everything that will be available with you also after the session.
Can it be Python code also? Can we use instead of R? Just a tool, right? I mean.
Yeah, that is just a tool, Chitra. So tool specific. Here we are implementing using R. If you wanted to, even I am working both on R and Python, but most of the requirement outside we are having on R, Chitra.
Oh,
so, okay, that is the reason we are covering here in R. If I spend more time on the tools, obviously you won't get the time to cover on the statistical techniques and machine learning algorithms. Because that is the major horse here. Okay?
Okay.
Here, if you cover really three different techniques, these things really can fulfill 70% of the business problems outside, friends. Now, first I will cover the first three techniques. After completion of those three techniques, after explaining the real-time problems, what you can do is, you can start the preparation of your profile. Even before completing the course itself, okay, you can start your preparation of your profile. And if you are comfortable with those three techniques, you can start your interviews before completing our course. Okay. Previously, in my trainings, almost 30% of the people, those who are having the real interest on this particular theme, 30% of the people, they place before the completing the course finish. Okay, even if you have, if you are putting 3 to 4 years of experience, if you put the three real-time examples and the three techniques, okay, that is more than enough. Okay, if any of your friends are working on analytics, just you can check with them. How many models, how many new models, not the existing models, how many new models they developed in their experience. In my entire 12 years of experience, I developed new models at max 10 models. Okay, not the existing models. Running the existing models we do very regularly, but the development of the new models, okay, depends on the business requirement. We have to do that one. Okay, here when I say the three techniques, these are the major techniques. Most of the real-time scenario, most of the companies face the different problems. For resolving those problems, majorly we use these three techniques. After completion of these three techniques, depends on which domain you are working accordingly. Okay, I can help you to prepare your profile so that you can focus on these three techniques and you can keep in your profile and you can start your interviews before completing the course itself. That is the part I can do. When it comes to the placements part, okay, Tech Labs is having, okay, the parent company is called Tech Doors. Through that one, okay, we support for the job also. But that purely depends on whenever I complete one real-time project in the session, immediately I will give you that one as exercise. The other project I will give you as a exercise. So you have to work on that exercise and you have to submit that result quickly, friends. Okay,
sure.
This way, after completion of the three techniques, immediately you can prepare your profile if you are really willing to move to the data science side, and you can start your interviews. And whatever the interview questions you are facing, even you can check that one before completing the course. Whatever the things we discuss in the session, 90% of the times you face the similar type of interview questions. Okay, if there is any change, if you feel something is different they are asking, then you can discuss with me. I can help you on that one before completing the course itself, right? Okay, even after completion of the course also, if you have any technical questions regarding a particular concept or if you have any questions regarding a particular project, okay, we continue the sessions very regularly. I will take the 3 to 4 sessions daily. You can join in any batch regarding your questions, and again you can rejoin and you can listen the sessions, friends. That feasibility is there. Okay, here we will help you for the resume preparation, and Tech Doors will support you regarding the job, and we cover all the real-time projects here. Initially, when I'm saying a real-time project, some of the people might be having the questions, we are not from the statistics background, so is it possible to understand all these mathematical equations and the techniques? Here the thing is, in the initial first 15 days, I will teach you all the basic concepts. If you remember, in our 10th standard, we studied mean, mode, and median, right? We start from there under the assumption of you are not aware of any statistics. With that assumption, we start our course. Okay, when I say all the statistical concepts, I won't cover the derivatives part, integrations. The derivations is not required because we are not doing the PhD. So I will explain what is the importance of that concept, where we use that concept, okay, how to generate the solution using that concept, using its specific tool. Okay, that way for each and every concept we connect to the real-time example, and I will explain all the basic concepts. Once you are comfortable with the basic concept, then we move to the real-time techniques and real-time project steps. Okay, this is the structure of the course. If you need the content of the course, okay, you can communicate with Mona. She can share all the content and the remaining information with you. And if you have any other questions, just let me know, friends, so that I can answer now.
Sure. Thanks.
Do you have any other questions, friends? Balki, Mona, sorry, Ramesh, Reshma, is it clear so far?
How many classes you have?
Okay, Chitra,
How many
here in general we plan for 60 hours from my end, Chitra. Again, parallelly,
Okay.
we have to spend 60 to 90 hours from your end.
What is the total duration? That means,
To complete
is
the course, I will take 60 hours. I mean, within 2 months, we can complete the course.
Two months. Okay.
Right. Parallelly, you have to spend 60 to 90 hours in your daytime. Sometime, you have to complete all the exercises.
Wow. Okay. Okay. Thanks.
So, do you want me to show any example or is it okay? If you are
Yeah, you
comfortable,
can.
then I can close. Otherwise, if you wanted to see any real-time example, one of the example I can show you and I can help you to understand the things, friends. What do you
Sure,
say?
please.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah.
Okay, let me show you one of the example. So everyone is able to see my screen, friends. So I'm explaining one of the basic business problem, friends. Here the problem is, here I'm dealing one of the manufacturing customer. Okay, their problem is, you know, when I say the manufacturing, they won't do the manufacturing on daily basis, right? Huge organizations, huge manufacturing plants. They plan for the 6 months, they do the bulk manufacturing, agree? Okay, this is also for regarding one of the manufacturing customer. What they are doing is, in advance they are manufacturing for the requirement of the next 6 months, but unfortunately for that particular customer, what is happening is, every time, sometimes they are doing the quantity they are maintaining in higher side, sometimes they are maintaining the quantity in lower side, friends. Okay, let's say if I am the manufacturer, if I manufacture the product 1000 units, if I have the requirement of only 500 units in the market, then what about the remaining 500? I have to maintain this one in some godowns, right? What indirectly it is referring? Unnecessarily, I am investing lot of amount on this particular thing initially, right? There is a loss of interest. I can spend that amount somewhere else. And the second thing is, whatever the stock I am not selling, those things again I have to maintain the stock in godowns, right? I have to pay the rent for that one. Again, the major problem in the industry is the technology. If the technology got upgraded, then anyone prefer to buy the old products?
No.
Okay, that is again loss, right? Also the expiry date. All these things comes under the picture, right? So in the other side of the coin, if I maintain the lower stock, what happens? Customer is really looking for that product, but that product is not really available in the market. Is the customer waits until again I launch that product into the market? Obviously, nowadays in the market, we have a lot of competitors are there, right? In most of the cases, customer won't wait until again you launch that product into the market. There is a possibility of customer may switch to the different product. So you are losing a customer here, right? So here you are having two problems. If I maintain the stock in higher side, okay, unnecessarily you are investing a lot of amount. There is a possibility of, okay, losing a lot of amount. If you maintain the stock in the lower side, the problem is there is a possibility of customer may switch to the different product, right? So to avoid that problem, what the customer is saying that is, every time we are facing these type of problems, now I am providing the historical data from February 2012 to June 2017. Okay, what is the quantity of the sales it was happened? Okay, this is exactly not 8025, friends. This is a very huge number. Okay, I converted, I transformed this number. Don't bother about the numbers right now. Okay, here they provided in each and every month what the sales they are having. They provided that information to us, friends. Now their question is, okay, this is the historical data we are having. We have the data until June 2017 or something. This is the old data, so that I am having the data until June 2017, friends. Now their business objective is, by studying all these historical data, please tell me what is the sales is going to happen in next 6 months. If you are able to predict or if you are able to estimate that one, accordingly I can plan my manufacturing process so that I can avoid these two different problems. Am I clear, friends?
Yes.
Is the business problem clear with everyone? Chitra, Ramesh and Reshma?
Yeah.
Please respond, friends.
Clear.
If the business problem is not clear, you won't be able to get anything. So if you are not clear, again, I can explain. Ramesh and Reshma? So, to resolve this business problem, as I mentioned, I have to understand how the sales is happening historically. I have to study all the trend and seasonal patterns and different things. Okay, using one of the statistical techniques, I have to perform the analysis and I have to generate the report what is going to happen in future trends. For doing that one, here I use this small R commands. Don't bother about the R at this point of time. Okay, I have to use small R commands and using one of the technique, I have to perform the analysis, friends. Okay, this is the interface of the R tool. Okay, at the time of the course, I can guide you. First, if I wanted to perform the analysis, I have to load the data into R, right? Whatever the data I am showing there. Okay, I am loading the data into R. Can you see the data here? This is the data we discussed, right? Each and every month what the sales we are having. Now the data is ready. Now what I have to do is, I have to perform the analysis. How to perform that analysis is, here I use one of the technique is called ARIMA. Okay, ARIMA is one of the technique, that is a time series technique, friends. Here I am referring the techniques and machine learning algorithms you have to learn, right? At the time of the course, I will guide you what is this ARIMA in detail. Okay, here, as I am aware of this business problem and as I am aware of this technique, I know that ARIMA is one of the technique it can resolve this business problem. So I am implementing that ARIMA technique and I am generating the solution. Now the model is ready. Now you can perform the summary of your model. Now it is giving what is the next 6 forecasted values. Can you see here? Earlier you have the observations until only June 2017, I mean 65 observations. From 66th observation onwards, these are the future predicted values. Okay, now you can export all these results outside from R. Finally, we provide the solution like this, friends. Can you see here? I have done for 6 months, right? Now here I am forecasting for the coming next 14 months. What the sales we can expect in the future using the ARIMA technique I am generating. In July, you can expect 5,520 units. In August, you can expect 4,456 units. Okay, this is the future estimation we are providing using the ARIMA model. Am I clear, friends? Now, the next immediate question is, you are talking about the future, right? Why should I believe these numbers? Agree? Any business person can ask, right? So you are generating using some mathematical computations or you are using some techniques or whatever it may be. If I wanted to implement this thing in my business, after implementing this one, if it won't happen, unnecessarily I lose my business, right? But you are talking about the future. Why should I believe your future numbers? For that one, what we do is, they are having their existing data, right? For that existing data, by using the same model, whatever the model you implemented to estimate the future values, okay, you can estimate the same thing using your model for the existing data also, you can forecast the values. Now the column number C is something, these are the actual sales values. The column number H is something, these are the values we have generated using our model. Now you can compare what is the difference between the actual sales and the forecasted sales. Then you can check what percentage of the deviation we are having. We have one of the metric is there, that is called MAP. Here using this one, I can identify the deviation between the actual value and your estimated value. I mean your predicted value using your model, the deviation is only 7%. I mean 93% of the numbers, I mean 93% of the things you are explaining very properly. So 93% of the accuracy explaining in advance is a really good thing. So even for the future period also, the 93% of the commitment, 93% of the chance of happening, the same thing. Not exactly chance, okay? There might be having the deviation of only 7%, but mostly 93%, the same sales will happen here also. So that accordingly, you can plan your manufacturing things and you can maintain your stock optimally so that you can avoid the two business problems. You need not to maintain the stock higher side or lower side. Consistently, you can maintain and you can improve your revenue. This way, we provide the solutions, friends. Okay, now if you understand what I have done to resolve this business problem, as I explained here, first you understand the business problem of the customer, right? Now here, as I am aware of the techniques, I am implementing one of the technique that is called ARIMA. Trust me, friends. ARIMA is one of the concept I studied. That is one of the time series concept. That is one paper in my entire semester. But you need not bother about what is the internal algorithm, derivatives and integration. Those are not required. We are implementing. We have the tool support is there. We are implementing using one of the tool. But I won't say you need not to know about anything. At the time of the course, I will teach you what is the ARIMA, how to implement that technique, what is the importance of that one, for what type of a business problems we have to implement that technique in detail, internally how the techniques will work. In high level, I will explain that part and I will show you the real-time examples, friends. Now I am implementing the ARIMA technique here. How I am implementing using the R tool. Finally, I am generating the solution. Am I clear?
Yes.
This way we provide the business solutions, friends. Yeah, I know that at this point of time, this might be little difficult to understand in higher level. Before coming to this point, as I am mentioning, initially I will cover all the basic concepts. Okay, you feel comfortable while learning this particular part, friends.
Sure.
Okay, when it comes to the demand of the data science in the market, okay, even you can check and you can inquire about that one. We have a lot of demand is there, but the proper data scientists are not available in the market, but we have very huge demand is there in the marketplace. Even if you learn one time on the data science, that is forever, you can enjoy. You need not bother about the tools, like every time it is upgrading, you need not bother about that part. Once you learn that one, irrespective of the industry, you are really fits for all the industries, and your role is generating, providing the business solutions. Okay, yeah, this is from my end, friends. If you have any questions, then we can discuss. If you don't have any other questions, then we can drop for now. And if you have any other technical questions, you can communicate with Mona. She can connect with me, then we can discuss on that part, friends. So, Ramesh, Reshma, Chitra, do you have any other questions, friends?
No, thanks.
Chitra, is it clear to
Thank you.
you? Initially, you mentioned you wanted to understand the concept, right? Is it okay?
It's very, very good. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Ramesh? Reshma? Yeah, please use your chat box, friends. Is it clear or do you have any other questions? Then thank you, friends. I'm closing for today. Okay, if you have any questions, you can communicate with Mona and she can connect with me. Thank you so much. Thanks for your time. Bye. Have a good day.
Thanks.
Bye. Yeah, one more thing. Sorry, friends. Hello, are you there?
Hello.
Hello. Yeah, so here after completing of the each and every session, what we will do is I have to share the material, right? Okay, I will give you the access to one of the drive. The drive will be available here. Once you are comfortable with the, you are ready to join this thing, then what we will do is after completion of each and every session, okay, I will give you the access to one of the drive. Here you can see all the videos, okay, all the interview questions, whatever the tools you require, everything will be available in this particular drive, friends. Okay, for each and every session, the video will be available, okay, and the material and the sample data sets, R code, everything will be available in this drive. And the real-time examples and the real-time projects and the interview questions, everything will be available in this drive. So that even after completion of the session, if you wanted to go through this technique again, okay, you can go through that video. And after that, again, if you have any questions, every time I will be available to resolve your problems. Okay? this is the stuff. In this way, we will provide the material and all the interview questions and all the videos. It will be available after completion of each and every class. You can download these videos and you can keep it with you. These things will help you for your future reference. All the 60-hour sessions will be available with you. Okay.
Thanks.
Yeah, then thank you, friends. See you soon. Thank you. Thanks for your time. Bye.
Thanks.